yes, it's a Taylor. An elusive, what do they call this? A T-45?
No, a T-5, sorry.
My mistake, I don't know. Okay, well anyway, it's on my bench. I've never seen one. They stopped making them because it didn't really take off. And I think Fender sort of came up with something like this that was way more economical. Who knows? Anyway, I pooped a little when I plugged it in. Wait and see. Well, I didn't even plug it in. I pooped a little before I plugged it in. So, I love it. It's lightweight. Oh, get the camera. Slope back a little bit into the movie here. Anyway, so I put it on the bench and I did the old, you know, what was you gonna strum at, right? Like, right? And I'm going, oh no, really? Come on now. This is an expensive thing. Like, what happened, right? What happened? Why is it doing this, right? Okay, so here it is. I'm gonna do the end at the beginning. What has happened? All right, okay, so in the description below, you can get a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker. You can become a patron. I totally appreciate all my patrons, and they know that I am there if you need to contact me. What else has happened? You can join the Facebook group. You can subscribe. Subscribing is easy. That's the Facebook group. Well, okay. If you post shitty memes, you're gone. No time for that. 10,000 people for all posting garbage. Guess what? The whole group becomes garbage. So you can't have that. So that's a zero strike rule. One. Gone. Sorry. What else happened? Oh, if you see any adverts for merchandising with my logo on it, people have stolen my logo and are selling shirts and coffee cups and hoodies, and this is what the world's become. We're just going to steal your logo and hire a third party company to create merchandise, and we're going to steal the money. Okay, anyway, I shut that down immediately. So don't, if you see any of that, no. The only thing you can get is a sticker, and it comes from me, and that's through PayPal, and that's below. What else happened? Oh, copyright strike guy. I'm not going to name you, but you know who you are. YouTube sends me a message that says someone has stolen my video footage. And I have a look, and sure as shit, hey, that's my footage with some other asshat voicing over it. So I clicked the buttons and I asked that it be taken away. Okay, so just so you know there, crybaby, I'm not out there making false strikes against copyright. YouTube tells me that you stole my video footage. I didn't like sit at home here and dream this shit up. So shut the fuck up and let's look at a Taylor guitar. Cheers. Oh, and just to add to that little rag, I get flag tagged and bagged if I play three chords that sound like a song, okay? So don't steal someone's pictures and then talk over it. For fuck's sakes, folks. Right? You know, that really frosts my flakes, I'm sorry. So before I started to fidget with this at all, I went to the Taylor website and looked up the gauge of strings that they use on it. They use Elixir, 11 to 49. I couldn't get them. We're going to use these 11 to 49. Very important to keep that straight. But then back to this, right? Wait for it. Wait for it. There's no battery in the back. And there's no tension on this shitty little door. Unless the battery's in there. Yeah, there's a crappy piece of foam that'll turn to dust in about a year. So, there you go. Right? That's it. Right? I pooped. Right? Right? And if I put... Are you joking me? You guys can check out the price point on this and get back to me. So it really doesn't appear it needs much except a battery in it to stop it from rattling. I'm going to open it up just because I can. I want to see what's in there. They got two strap buttons. Not quite sure what that's about. The neck right now is, well, tiny bit too straight, not too much. But the string action is really nice and low. And you got that. It's built in distortion. String action is great. I guess to hear what it does, we have to plug it in. But I really want to look inside here to see what the frick they got in there. Probably not much. Well, you cob gobblers are right here with me. I have no idea. Wait, it'll be nothing. It's like, pay no attention to man behind the curtain. Right? It'll be like two wooden matches and a couple of elastic bands. Oh, maybe that was the sound we heard. There was no back. Yeah. But apparently those that have, you know, played acoustic guitar live, which isn't acoustic guitar, is this a suction pig? Doesn't work. Oh, there he goes. It'll probably break that in the process. Oh, look at it. Look how fantabulously shitty it is. That's it. Is there a preamplification thingamajiggity? Gotta be somewhere hidden in here. Where is it? This wire goes way to the output. Battery. Oh, that's a circuit board. Where'd they hide it? And then there's that. Oh, it's up here in this big pile of stuff. Let's just close this up and pretend we never looked inside. And before I close it up, I'd point out that they went to great lengths to put some sort of fuzzy foam here so that this would fit nice and not wiggle around. But then three longs, two shorts. Yeah, something like that. Okay. Yes, it is true. Right? You should never leave a battery in a guitar that has a battery in it. I don't even know why we did that in the first place, but here's a way to blow it up. Which one's plus, Dad? Oh, son. Okay, so that takes up the slop of the door. So now, when you play it, let's plug it in, see what happens. Then we're going to take the strings off it, clean it up, and what are all these little... These, what are those candies? They're like... I can't remember the name of the candy. It's not Smarties. They could be brown Smarties, but it's another one. Skittles, right? They use Skittles
electric control knobs.
Well, that's somewhat disappointing. Did anyone even try it with a battery before they bought it? Oh, stand by. The brand new dollar store battery was absolutely brand new and dead. To get in there and clean that, because I don't have any Skittles to replace these. They're cleaned up once I got into it. So you get this little red light here at the end of the shifter. Just those have a center, so we'll put them there. I guess that's the two pickup volumes and. See, that sucks. That's not $3,000, I'm sorry. Can I get in there? No. You bastards. You see? I'm going to be spinning this to 9,999 million times. I'll be back. I didn't really want to go in here. This seems to be the only way to go in there. Because the big hole in the back, that's how they suck all this stuff inside. And I'm hoping I can just maybe see that control and shoot some juice in there. And it won't make that noise. Because we don't like that kind. Well, that was a stupid idea. That is not coming out of there. And even if it does come out of there, it doesn't come out of there. It all goes in from there. So, two options. Try and push some cleaner in from the top, but it's a bunch of those wacky plastic potentiometers mounted into a frickin' circuit board. Yeah. So what I'm hoping for is this will drizzle down through the shaft and not eat the plastic. I think that's what they wanted to have happen. Oh, that's just so disappointing, right? Imagine standing on stage in front of no. Maybe. Come on, baby. You can do it. Do the potentiometer shuffle. Wow. Did I get it? And you find out after you've done all that, it doesn't make sound at all. You actually finished breaking it. Those seem okay. Please. The shifter. Okay, let's put new strings on it and get the hell out of this. The creepy truss rod hole, which I'm sure no one has ever opened since this guitar was born. You gotta get over it, folks. You know, I get it. The people are, you're right. I can't deal with Dave's, what's the other one? Vulgar language. Okay. Wow, that is just fucked up. Like, look, it looks like somebody had, they eat a caramel candy and spit it out because they didn't like it. It's like, whoa, okay. Anyway, back to the trust fund. It's like, I'm going to say it. Sorry. It's like the first time you ever actually see a real vagina. You know? First time you actually see a vagina. Like in real life. Right? Either you step up to the challenge or you run away scared. Your choice. Okay, so you're here with me. I'm not quite sure what to think about that snot that's on there. Is it glue? Is it paint? Is it, I don't know, crystal meth? Well, they've copied the Gibson scale. Give me a second here. I want to make sure this is straight. Okay, so without string tension, we'd want to tighten this up a bit, but I just want to make sure it loosens. And it does. And it turns. I have no idea what that blob of shit is in there, but I'm not touching it. That works. Okay, I'm calling that straight. It's cleaned up. It stopped making noise. That was disparaging. I that's like, ooh, that's not user friendly. Don't lose your Skittles. That's what's happening. Oh, be careful. Don't touch it while you're working on it. Sorry, my bench isn't like fucking hospital clean. I'm gonna start swearing a lot soon too. Nobody's gonna like me by the time this is done. It's usually how it ends with most relationships for me. Is that by the time it's over, and I've done my best, and I've tried my hardest, and I realize I'm hanging around with a bunch of freaking idiots, I'm not really sad they don't like me anymore, am I? Oh, I'm also in the mood to talk to folks out there who are really super hypercritical about how their guitar looks. Okay, so I've said this before, it's sort of like my car. I really like the way my car looks, but the only time I see my car is when I'm walking up to it. When I'm driving it, only people that I'm passing see. It's kind of like that with your guitar on stage. Right? And really, you'd be hoping they'd be looking at you and your haircut and not your guitar. But maybe the guitar nerds out there are looking at your guitar and they're noticing that there is a minor chip in the upper bout. They're also noticing that your song fucking sucks and you can't play. Oh, no, really? Did they say that? I can't even remember where I was. Oh, no, I won't where I was. I went to bed. I just sit overnight. And now I come to realize that once I set the neck relief, string action seems a little bit high. So I'm thinking we're gonna have to shave a little bit off of that to make it play as nice as it could. And no, I'm not clipping off the strings to the very end. Carry on.
do we have? We have string action sitting at 7 64s. I would like it to be 5. That means 2 64s. Or 30 seconds times 2 equals
a 16th of an inch.
Woohoo! All possible. Lots of bridge settling.
Okay, get your headphones turned up really loud. Okay? Really loud, loud as they go.
That's sort of it. String action's really nice now. I'm gonna measure that. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe, maybe not. Right, right! Now we're gonna measure it. Come here. I should check the relief again, but wow, that's exactly where I wanted it to be. Isn't that wonderful? Oh yeah, it plays like a dream. I will plug it in and shift through the different tones. I think I got rid of that noise. Got everything full blast, and then there's like the shifter arm here, right? On the top that shifts through whatever it does. So that's the first position. Center spot. So does that one. So does that one. What's that do? Anyway, that's it. Taylor T5. I can see that in the right hands, this could be a very useful item. Don't you agree? I agree. All the great links to things are below me in the description. What else? I don't know. Thanks to all my patrons. Thank you, thank you. Facebook group people, be nice. That's all I gotta say. Don't post any stupid crap. You know the crap I mean? The crap that everybody's seen 80 frickin' times already by the time you see it, and then you laugh, and then you... No. No more of that meme. You can't do that. Because, as I pointed out, the group has, 8,000 plus members. So if everybody post the meme every day, well, the whole group would be rendered useless, wouldn't it? So post that shit on your own shit. If that makes any sense. Send it to your mom. Let her look at it. Clipping the strings. What else is going on? Not much. Big shout out to my friends up at Solo Guitars for constantly helping me out. When most other places don't have any parts.
Yeah, so, you know, you can get a Dave's World of Fun Stuff sticker. Come on now. And most importantly, you can be good to each other. Cheers.